I'm starting off there. You said crank it up a notch if you can. The things of course.
We're going.
What equals a certain point? It's a system of equations. What equals a point? I'm gonna think of something else.
I don't know.
All of them, like they form a line, basically.
That's a graph of one equation. Like all of the solutions to one equation, when you put them on a graph, you know, they make a shape. You'd be graphing lines. Well, a system of equations is just two or more equations. That's what a system is. So you got your nodes, and take notes. Right here, and there. It's easy to spot you when there's five of you. So a system of equations is just multiple equations. Let me just first show you one equation. Just one equation. Here's one. Negative 3x minus y equals 8. There's an equation. There it is. There's one of them. I'll write another one. And when I write this other one down, that's what turns it into a system of equations. Okay, so now we're up to about 30, okay, on our journey from 0 to 60.
Do you want us to solve this?
We will in just a second. So this is a system of equations, and in most systems of equations, like if I were to just randomly throw together two equations, it's probably going to have one and only one solution. Okay. Other choices might be zero solutions or infinity. Here we're just going to have one. Okay, we learned about graphing. Not a great approach. We learned about substitution. Much better. Substitution is much better. And then 7.3 here is about elimination. Okay, elimination happens when we try to put two equations together by adding them. We add them together. Okay. So if I were to add these two equations together, the variable sides together and the number sides together, what will I have on the left side?
Negative 4.
Close. You got negative 3x plus 7x.
Is 4x.
It's 4. So positive 4x. Then we have negative y plus y. We're just collecting like terms here, right? We put the x's together, we wind up with 4x's. Put the y's together, what do we wind up with?
4. 0.
0. We have negative x plus, or sorry, negative y plus y.
Oh.
0y. And what's 8 minus 12?
Negative 4.
And then you would just divide by 1. Divide by 4, x equals?
Negative 1.
Mm-hmm. Negative 1, right? And that's it?
No.
You gotta go back and figure out what y is.
Exactly.
Was that?
Exactly.
Oh, exactly, yes. So let's put it in here, in this equation. So 7 times negative 1 plus y equals negative 12. Negative 7 plus y equals 12. We'll add 7 to both sides. And y equals negative 5. Negative 1. Negative 5. So if we follow that, we're at about 55. Take us to 60 is this.
I help.
Yeah, question, let me back up.
Yeah. All right, so for the negative 3 and the negative 7, whatever it is on the bottom, like you would add negative 3 and 7 for the x, but what would happen if the 7 was negative and the 3 was positive? Would you subtract those two?
Well, we're just, in both cases we're adding, okay? And what's different is which number is negative.
Right.
That you're suggesting. So if I add a negative 3x plus 7x, that's correct. It's negative 3x plus 4x is 7x. If this was positive and this was negative,
right,
then I would have a 3x plus a negative 7x, 3x plus negative 7x, which is the same as 3x minus 7x. That would be negative 4x.
Right. Right. Talking about like on the bottom, or whatever it shows on the bottom, we made of that 7 on the top from the very beginning.
Ah.
Yes. If that was a negative and the
positive, this was negative, you get a negative 4x instead of a positive 4x. Okay, so that just so happens to work out nicely because this y and this y, they're opposites. We can add them together, we get 0. So we're at 55. Now let's go right up to 60, and then we'll go to 60.5. Okay. Let's see. So we got negative 8y plus 6x equals 36. And our other equation, which is what turns it into a system, 6x minus y, equals 15. Alright, so let me do something that's not really necessary here, because hopefully what we understand is that when we add a bunch of variable terms together, we can only add the like variables together. I can't add x's to y's and y's to x's. Y's to y's and x's to x's. So I would combine like terms. You can rewrite this if you would like in alphabetical order, so everything lines up in straight columns, and that's kind of nice to look at. So we could just change this one to 6x minus 8y equals 36.
Would it be plus? Oh, wait. Okay.
So the sign follows the term around. This is 6x. Minus y equals 15. So now they line up. So we're going to add them both together. They line up vertically, and that's a nice thing. What's going to take us from 55 to 60 is seeing, well, if I were to add these together, what would 6x plus 6x be?
12x.
I don't think that's what I want. What's negative 8y minus y? Negative 9y, and then 36 plus 15. I already know that this is not what I want. 36. This is not what I wanted. What did I want to have happen? Hint, it happened here.
You wanted the x to cancel each other?
Yeah, to be really specific to this problem, we were kind of hoping the x's would cancel, right? You said x's instead of y's because the x's, they look very, very close to each other. And so did these ones back here, the y's in this problem, right? They were like perfectly opposite each other so that they cancel each other out.
All those ones are the same.
So yeah, they're the same number, but they don't have the opposite signs. What to do?
Well, they could times negative 1.
That's what we're going to do. We're going to multiply, it doesn't matter which one, whether it be this equation or this one, just multiply both sides by negative 1. And now everything will have the opposite sign. So in true equation fashion, when we work with equations, we have to do the same thing to both sides. So we're going to multiply this by a negative 1. We multiply this by a negative 1. Same thing to both sides. We have to distribute this negative to both of these guys. We get negative 6x plus y equals negative 15. No problem there. Perfectly legal.
So
multiply both sides by the same thing.
How would you get the
How would you get this negative 1?
Yeah.
Well, because we're just doing it to both sides, we could chose anything. We could have multiplied both sides by negative 3/4. Could have been anything.
You could have used any number.
Any number at all. But we'll use a negative 1 because, as Cameron pointed out, they have the same number. They have the same coefficient, right? Both have a 6. But if we add them together, we want them to cancel out. One needs to be a 6, and the other one needs to be
negative
6. So we're turning one of them into a negative 6.
So it always has to be the opposite number.
Yeah, for elimination to work, you're going to have the opposite number.
Okay.
And we'll just bring this equation down exactly the way it looks. 6x minus 8y equals 36. Now when we add everything together, what's negative 6x plus 6x? And y plus a negative 8y, or y minus 8y, negative 7y, negative 15 plus 36, or 36 minus 15, is that
21?
Nope. If Divide by negative 7. 3. Y is negative 3. And y is negative 3, so we got to figure out what x is.
So you just, wouldn't you just pick one?
Anything. Yeah, you can pick this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Any of them. Okay. I'll plug it into this one. Because there's like 8 in front would make it maybe a little harder. The number's a little bit smaller here. So that's the one I choose. You don't have to choose it. So make sure you got your signs correct. It's a negative there. And y is negative 3, so it's negative, negative 3. That's 6x plus 3 equals 15. Subtract 3, subtract 3. 6x equals 12. X equals 2. Solution is 2, negative 3. 2, negative 3. So it's at multiplying by negative 1 takes us from 55 to 60. Okay, now we're up to 60. We've gone 0 to 60. We started out with what is a system of equations? It's just a couple of equations. And we took it all the way up to 7.3. We skipped over graphing to solve and substitution. And writing word problems for substitution. And we've gone right into elimination, eliminating by adding both of the equations together. Now, one little thing that we, from 55 to 60, is just if both of the numbers are the same, 6x and 6x, for example, you know one of them has to be negative, so you just choose one of those equations, multiply by a negative 1, and we have it.
I can go back.
Yes.
Want to know something weird?
That's what's making the equator bigger around than this way around?
Yeah. It's like making it to an oval shape.
Spherally.
Yeah, sure.
Another interesting fact. Like that, it's obviously not perfectly round as well because it's bumpy. Right?
Oh, yeah. But, like,
but here's my interest. That if you look at the Earth zoomed out, like a picture from the moon or something, it looks very smooth, but then it's bumpy when you zoom in on it, right? We're zoomed in on it right now. It's very bumpy. If you were to take a billiard ball, like a cue ball, right, and blow it up to the size of the Earth,
it'd be bumpy.
It would be more bumpy than the Earth. Like the Earth is... If aliens played pool with Earth and other planets, the Earth would be smoother than the cue balls we use when we play pool.
Really?
Yeah. It's just, I guess there's less variation between the highs and lows on Earth, like these mountains and stuff, than there is on a cue ball. If you zoomed in on a cue ball, you'd probably see like these really deep cracks relative to its size. That was something I heard a long time ago. Reminded me of it when you mentioned that.
What would happen if the Earth just reversed its rotation?
Polarity. We all die.
Earth would
never really know what happened.
Another ice age?
No, like it just.
Because it depends on how fast that happened.
So, like, now the sun goes from east to west, it'll go from west.
That's one thing that would happen. Mess up a lot of stuff.
No, like it,
but I wonder if it would mess up. It would mess up time, right? In a way.
Like it
I
just.
So I mean, as long as it spins at the same speed, it would mess us up.
No, because like
it would take just as long for that to happen.
It doesn't slow down, it just kind of like reverses.
It's like really quick.
Yeah, like
then really quick, we all die.
We would.
Yeah.
How?
Like the forces that would require the Earth to stop that quickly would kill us all.
If I was gently.
Well, then we would, just like, depending on how long it would take, we could, like, our seasons would be thrown out of whack. We might have another ice age. One half of the Earth would always be in shadow while it's doing this transition.
And we'd have, like, 2 days, basically. We'd have one long 24 hours of complete sunlight in some place. Right?
If it just took 2 days to happen?
That'd be 40.
I think we'd still die.
Like, it just got done with the day, and then it switched back, and, like...
Would time reverse? Would we go backwards in time?
No. Superman, what's the line? We can go back in time.
We could go back in time.
All right, well, let's keep addressing this issue here. If we're going to use the idea of elimination to solve the system of equations, we would try and add these equations together, right? We have an issue. It looks kind of good, but when we add it together, 7x plus 7x is what?
14x.
We would rather have this 7x plus a negative 7x and eliminate the x, right? Go 0x. So I'm going to kind of do a shorthand here. I'll take this equation, or this one, it doesn't matter. I just tend to use the bottom one for no reason at all.
Okay.
And multiply it by a negative 1. We just need one of those x terms to be the opposite. So let's just bring everything down, right? One line down here. So I'll just rewrite this first equation. Maybe I'll color code this. This will be red.
Thanks.
This will be red. So I'll rewrite the red one. 7x minus 2y equals 5. Now I'm going to multiply this black one by negative 1. We get negative 1 times 7x is negative 7x. Negative 1 times negative 3y is positive 3y. Negative 1 times 4 is negative 4. Make sure you get the other side of the equation too. Don't just multiply this side.
You could, no matter the problem, as long as it's like that, all you can do is parenthesize the entire problem and just multiply that by negative 1.
Yeah, I mean, by putting parentheses around the thing, I'm just saying, I'm multiplying this equation or
you're
both sides of this equation by a negative 1.
Okay.
So, yeah. As long as we do the same thing to both sides, we haven't really disrupted the equation we're working with, and so I'll multiply both sides by negative 1, and now the nice thing happens. 7x plus a negative 7x is 0x. And that's eliminated. And 3y, or negative 2y plus 3y, ooh, that's nice. Right? Just a y, and it's going to make solving for y easy. And a 5 minus 4? Is what?
Negative 1.
5 minus 4
is just
positive 1.
Yeah.
And I'm going to take this positive 1, I'm going to put it in this equation. Put it in that one, it'll work the same. 7x minus 2 times 1 equals 5. I don't like it. It's equal. So 7x minus 2 equals 5. We'll add 2 to both sides. 7x equals 7. X equals 1 as well.
1.
1 for x, 1 for y. We solve the equation.
11.
Okay, we're still kind of just driving at 60. Okay.
Not really? I got reserved for
that. What are you going to be doing anything else for that other than?
Well, not other than solving systems of equations, but. One little thing. So like I said, it's just like a half a notch. Yeah, it's not. I think really half a notch is not the same half as a half
mile
an
hour.
Yeah. This is 7 minutes.
Is already exploding.
A little bit.
The fuse is a bit.
Yes, you can. The flip is about to get there. This one half notch is going to be your goal.
So we've got this elimination idea. If we add the equations together and two of the terms are exactly the opposite of each other, they'll eliminate each other. That's what I call elimination. So, and sometimes we have to help that along by making one of them negative on the other stays positive so that they can do that thing. They can eliminate each other. But let's throw it another little half a notch in there and say that our two equations are 5x plus 2y is equal to 16, and 3x minus 4y is equal to 20. Now, if I try this again, if I try adding together these equations, I'm going to get 5x plus 3x is 8x, and 2y minus 4y is negative 2y equals 36. Like, none of that helps. It didn't help at all. When we add two equations together, what we're hoping will happen is one of the terms will get eliminated, or the x or the y will get eliminated. That didn't happen, and the thing we've been doing, like in this example,
won't cut it,
yeah. Because these two happen to be the same, right? The same number, we just need to make one of them opposite, and we're ready to go. Well, that's not going to work. I can't just multiply one of these by negative 1, because none of these numbers is the same, right? So that's not going to work. But somehow I would like either the x's to be exactly opposite, like positive 20 and negative 20, or the y's to be the opposite, positive 12 and negative 12. But neither one of them, not even really close to that. We can try substitution. We can go back to that. But we can still use elimination. It's the same idea as multiplying by negative 1 on both sides, except, well, we're not going to multiply by negative 1. We're going to multiply by something else. Notice that...
60.
Well, just notice that these are already, one's positive and one's negative. So that, in a way, is like a step in the right direction. But like this would need to be positive 2 and this negative 2, or this needs to be negative 4 and this positive 4. Can I make this positive 4? Can I multiply this by something to get positive 4?
You can multiply by 2 to get that.
So we can multiply both sides of this by 2. Okay. So multiply this by 2 and this by 2 and this by 2. And we get 10x plus
32
equals 32. We got the second equation here, 3x minus 4y. Now this is going to work. Equals 20. So now, when we add these together, 10x plus 3x is 13x, and 4y minus 4y is 0. So exactly what we wanted to have happen. So in this equation, we have this system of equation multiplied by negative 1. Here we multiply this equation by a 2. The idea is, the goal is to get either the x's or the y's in each of the equations to be opposite each other. So 4y minus 4y is 0, and 32 plus 20 is 52. Divide by 13 equals 4. X equals 4. Now that x equals 4, we'll plug it into an equation. I'll put it in this equation because y is positive there. 5 times 4 plus 2y equals 16. 20 plus 2y equals 16. Subtract 20. Subtract 20. 2y equals negative 4. And y equals negative 2. So divide by 2. Here is whatever it takes by way of multiplying both sides of the equation by something. We want to get the x's or y's to be opposite. By opposite, I mean 4y and negative 4y. Or the previous example, the x's, 7x and negative 7x. So we add them together, we get 0. Or we did it here with the x's, negative 6x and positive 6x. So when we add them, we get 0x. And whether we multiply by a negative 1, or multiply by a 2, or whatever we multiply by, we just want them to be opposite each other. So that when we add them together, they eliminate each other. Let's give another one a try. Let me find one while you maybe finish copying that down. One down as I write it down. 19 2x plus 3y. Looks fine. So again, just like my little note here says, let's try and get the x's or the y's, our choice, whichever, doesn't matter, to be opposite. We're going to do that by choosing an equation and multiplying both sides by something so that the x's or the y's come out to be opposite. I'm going to start to turn it over to you a little bit. You know what we're trying to do. We're trying to get either the x's here to be opposite each other, okay, by multiplying one of the equations by something, or the y's to be opposite each other by multiplying one of the equations by something. Anybody see which equation we should multiply by? We should multiply both sides and by something. And what it is we should multiply both sides of that equation by? Let's take a look at both of those equations and see, does it feel like x's are kind of close to being opposite each other?
Times 3. Multiply -3.
3, but negative, right? So a negative. If we multiply this by a -3, we'll get a -6. Okay. I can't just multiply the x by -3, right? I gotta keep both sides balanced. Can't throw it out of whack. You gotta multiply both sides by -3. Very good. So if we were to multiply this by a -3, we get a -6x. It's exactly what we want. In order for that to happen, we have to multiply everything by -3. So this becomes a new system, 6x plus 5y equals 19. That didn't change. But this one's going to change to -3 times 2x is -6x. -3 times 3y is -9y. -3 times 5 is -15. Now, it's ready to go. We've set it up so that elimination is going to happen when we add both sides together. Now that we have, as this little note here says, Harvey helped us out and told us, in order to get the x's to be opposite, we multiply this equation by -3, and now the x's are opposite. Add the other 6x. -6x is
0.
5y minus 9y, 4y. 19 minus 15. 19 plus -15 is 4. Divide by -4. 4 divided by -4. Y was, now we'll figure out what X is. I'm going to use this first guy right here, 2X plus 3Y equals 5. Add 3 both sides, 2X equals 8, divide by 2X equals 4. Solution is 4, negative 1. Harvey showed us how to do that one.
Yeah.
So let's see if somebody else can take the reins here. It's gonna be a little bit more of a challenge is added here. let you think about it. If you don't figure it out, I'll help you. That's too much. This one's precious. Okay, 4x plus 5y equals 35. 4x plus 5y equals 35. 2y, let's write it like this. Negative 3x, so we don't have to think about too much at once, plus 2y equals negative 9. Beginning, we chose to multiply one of them by -1, and then we had to multiply one of them by 2, -3 to get the x's or y's at the opposite. But here it's not as clear. In this equation, I can multiply this by a -3 and get it to be the opposite of 6x. That doesn't seem to be possible here. I can't multiply this by anything and get a 4. I can't multiply this by anything and get a -3. I can't multiply this by something to get a 5. I can't multiply this by something to get a 2. But there's nothing saying that we can't do something different to both equations. So that is to say, I can multiply this equation by something and this equation by something else. And that way I can get the x's of my choice, x or y, to be opposite.
Could you use the 2 on the top?
Multiply by 2?
Yeah. Negative 2.
Negative 2? And?
You would distribute it.
Well, if I do multiply this by negative 2, let's see what I get. Negative 2 times 4 is negative 8x. Negative 2 times 5y is negative 10y equals 35. Now, if under that I write negative 3x plus 2y might equals negative 9, is that going to be what I want? That doesn't mean we haven't, like, we've done anything wrong. I didn't multiply the other side by negative 2, did I? Negative 70 is what we should have. No, I don't want this equation. We don't have opposites. Nothing's going to eliminate when we add. But instead of writing that, could we maybe multiply this equation by something else so that either the x's or y's? What's that?
2.
By 2?
I was thinking 3.
You're thinking 3 as well?
Yeah, but I don't know.
Sure which?
Whatever
it is, if the x's or the y's come out to be opposite, then great.
Oh, we have 3.
Multiply by 3? Okay. So let's see if the x's or y's come out to be opposite, we multiply by 3. 3 times negative 3x is negative 9x. So that didn't work out for the x's, right? Let's see about the y's. 3 times 2y is 6y. So, I mean, we multiply by 3 correctly, but neither the x's nor the y's came out to be opposites, right? If this had come out to be an 8, that would have been great. 8x minus 8x would have been 0. Or if this had come out to be a what?
10.
A 10, then negative 10y plus 10y would be 0. That would be great. So this doesn't look like 3 is what we're looking for now. What do you think?
I did it differently.
Well,
multiply the top number by 3.
Okay. Well, let's just work with what we started with. We certainly make this work.
Well, then you multiply 5 bottom.
Multiply this by 5. Let's see what happens if we do that. 5 times negative 3x is negative 15x. And what's 5 times 2y?
10.
Look at that. Just like we said, if this were a 10y, then that'd be good. It is. And 5 times negative 9 is negative 45. And we did exactly what the little note said. We made the y's be opposite. The y's are now opposite. So we add them together. Negative 8x minus 15x is negative 23. 3x. And I didn't write anything else because negative 10y plus 10y is 0. Negative 70 minus 45 is negative 115. So you divide by negative 23. And I don't remember my 23s on my times tables. So take 115 divided by 23. 5. And it's a negative divided by a negative. Negative divided by negative is?
Positive.
So it's going to be a positive 5. Now I got half the answer. X is 5, and then we'll figure out what y is. So put it in here. Negative 3 times 5. Plus 2 times y equals negative 9. Negative 15. Plus 2y equals negative 9. Add 15. 2y equals 6. And divide by 2, y equals 3. X is 5. Y is 3. Right, so here's the kicker in this system of equations. We multiply both equations by something. Now we're going like 65. It's about equivalent to half a notch. So going back to 60, when we were driving 60. Yeah, the big idea was to multiply one of the equations by a negative 1. And that would make something opposite. Made these x's opposite. Again, in this system of equations, we multiplied this equation by a negative 1 again, and the x's were opposite, 7x and negative 7x. But then, we moved on to multiplying by things other than negative 1. Multiplied this equation by 2, so that these guys became opposite. The y's became opposite in that case. We multiplied this by 2, we got 4y, there's our negative 4y, and they eliminated. Did it again, only this time it was a negative 3 that we multiplied by, so that we can get the x's to be opposite. Because we can see, just kind of intuitively, if I multiply this by a negative 3, I'll get a negative 6, and those will eliminate each other.
So basically, as long as they can actually equal something, one of the two up there, you can just multiply, like, times something.
Yeah, you can multiply an equation on both sides by anything you want.
Okay, just as long as like they actually do eventually equal something, so they can't be like, you know, one of them eliminated. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the strategy. I mean, we can multiply both equations by random numbers for no reason at all, but our strategy is multiply by things so that either the x or the y, it doesn't matter. In fact, Cameron said he tried this system of equations using different multipliers, right?
Yes.
So let's just steal these two equations, and perhaps some parentheses, and do it again on the next page. Copy. Next page. All right, so you said you took the top equation and multiplied by what?
3.
And the bottom equation by?
4.
Can you see what's going to happen when you multiply the top equation by 3, the bottom equation by 4?
They're going to come out to be the same.
Which ones?
The x.
The x's. They're both going to be 12s, right?
Mm-hmm.
But one of them will be negative, so we can eliminate that. So multiply this by 3, we get 12x. 3 times 5y is 15y. Remember, multiply the other side by 3. We get 105. Then we get 4 times negative 3x is negative 12x. 4 times 2 is 8. 8y. 4 times negative 9, negative 36. And this way, we eliminate the x's, and we'll figure out what y is first. The x's go away. 12x minus 12x is 0. 15y plus 8y is 23y. And that's equal to 105 minus 36 is... Don't plug in 3
yeah,
for
yeah, negative 9.
Why?
Negative
3. X plus 2 times 3 equals negative 9. Negative 3x plus 6 equals negative 9. Subtract 6 on both sides, we get negative 15. Divide by negative 3 on both sides, we get x equals 5. And we found, no surprise, 5 comma 3. We should always get the right answer, right? No matter what our approach. Multiply both sides by, or each equation by something different, whether it be negative 2 and 5, so we get opposite y's, or 3 and 4, so we get opposite x's, whatever, whichever we choose, we get opposite x's or opposite y's. So now we're going to do, nothing new. We're just going to do exactly the same thing as this last example. Different system. Just a slightly different system. Let's try this one. 7x minus 6y equals negative 1. 5x minus 4y equals what?
So again, for the, I don't know how many times I've said it, get either the x's or the y's.
Start with that. If you feel like you have to take it all the way to the end, just see if you can get the x's or the y's, your choice, to be opposite of each other. These I thought were good. So I'm going to start with Cameron. How did you start this, Cameron?
I took multiply 4 to 7x minus. Then I multiplied by negative 6 to 5x minus 1.
So to me it looks like you're targeting these y's?
Yes.
Y's opposite. Okay. So, tell me if we agree here, I'd get 28x minus 24y equals negative 4. And then multiplied by negative 6 down here, we get negative 30x plus 24y. And 1 times negative 6 is negative 6.
And that's beautiful.
It is beautiful. So we see that those are going to eliminate each other. Okay, we can figure all these out specifically in a minute. But I'm just going to go to approach number 2 from Harvey. What did you do, Harvey?
So I did 5 at the top.
Yes.
Yes. And then I got 35, and then negative 35 at the bottom.
Okay.
Yeah. And then for the top one, okay, I got negative 30y equals 4. And then at the bottom.
The only problem there, did you get 4? I think what you did was you took 5.
Oh. Yeah.
You should have done 5 times negative 1, so we should get
negative 4, right?
Negative
5, 6, 8. 20.
5 times negative 1. We're multiplying it, right? Multiplying the right side by 5. We should get negative 1.
Oh, geez. All right. So I got this correct.
That's right. Down here we should get?
Okay. Negative 28y.
Well, we have a negative.
Negative 60.
We have a negative.
Oh, no.
A negative times a negative.
Positive.
So positive 28.
70. 40.
And a negative 7 times y is a negative 7.
Yeah.
Well, you go in there, you fix those little mistakes, but the important part is that you learned this new thing,
right?
And you did set yourself up for the next step to eliminate the x's. Okay? And then Branson?
I did 2 on top.
You did 2 here,
and then negative 3 on bottom. Wrong.
Negative 3 on bottom. Let's see what happens.
I do not like that.
Let's see what happens. 2 times 7x is 14x.
Nope.
It. 2 times negative 6y is negative 12y.
Not proof.
2 times negative 1 is negative 2. All right, for the bottom one, negative 3 times 5x is negative 15x. Negative 3 times negative 4y, negative times negative is positive. We get a positive 12y. And negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. So interesting thing about this, Cameron eliminated the Y's instead of Branson, but Branson did it with a smaller number. Right? He made both 12s, opposite 12s, he made them opposite 24s.
You're better than Branson.
You're better than
And notice, Cameron, that he multiplied by 2 or you multiplied by 4. He multiplied by negative 3, you multiplied by negative 6. So your numbers are twice as big, and it's no surprise that 24.
Because I'm a big man.
Twice as big as 12.
Twice as
little room.
In this.
Of course, we're going to come up with the same solution in both of these, well, all three of these. Okay?
Okay.
But I just wanted to point that out. There's several different approaches. All get the same solution. I'll go ahead. We'll work on this bottom one since it's on the bottom.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll add these together. 14x minus 15x. What's that? Close.
Negative x.
Negative 1x. Negative 1y plus 12y is exactly what we want to have happen. It eliminates. Negative x equals negative 5, right? Negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. So x is 5. Since x is 5, we could plug it in. Let's put it right here. 5 times 5, x is 5, minus 4y equals 1. Well, minus 25, because that'll come out to be 25. Negative 4y equals negative 24, and y equals positive 6. When you divide by negative 4, both sides. So, 5 comes 6. This approach, Harvey's approach, Cameron's approach, all are going to get the solution 5, 6. Do we follow any of those approaches, any of those examples? They're all equally great.
I got 29.
Well, you did have some negatives and
yeah.
Some study. I think you just mean, sometimes you just got to erase all your work and just go back to where you know your first mistake was and just start from there. Right. So we might multiply one of the equations by a negative 1. We might multiply one of the equations by, you know, just one of the equations by something. And we might multiply both equations by different things. Whatever we're doing, you know, the end goal is to get either the y's to be opposite or the x's to be opposite. Or get the y's to be opposite, you know, two different options. So when we add the both the equations together, we get elimination. Okay? So I think a little practice is in order. So I didn't write the section number down here. This is 7.4. Good. Anything to get 7.3 done? Quite a bit of chunk of time here. Did you get that done?